Recording. Okay. Kannst du meinen Vater hören?
Ja, er hustet.
A little bit. Noch im Bett. Er schläft in the main floor.
Ah, ist er.
Aber okay. Ich habe Platz für ihn und ich gehe jetzt nach oben. Okay, wenn du fertig bist, wenn du bereit bist, dann.
Ja.
Und ich weiß nicht, wie lange das dauert, diese Recording, aber. Ja, los, Mercedes.
Yes. During the airlift, I was 7 years old and I had memories of the war. There was only not, you couldn't see. I remember I could see the rubbles there in the streets, and I can smell it. This was so a bad remembrance. And years later, in 1948, there was the same noise of the airplanes in the sky. I feared that that would be a new bombing to Berlin. I remember the air crash near our house. We are in the flight path to Airfield Tempelhof, and it was in the night, and I was very anxious about the situation, and my mother told me all is okay. And next morning when we went to this house, this apartment house, we saw all the surrounding were white and the pilots were dead. And then we feared that the West Allied would stop the supplies flying to Berlin. We hope that the West Allies would support us, because my grandma told me she would be, even she was hungry the whole time, she wouldn't be Russian, become Russian. She will die before starvation but never become Russian. And this was the same feeling all over in Berlin. We have there many refugees from East Prussia, Asia, and also the outbombed people in the houses here, in the apartments. We were coming together and were looking with great hope to the West Allies. And it was a great miracle, großes Wunder for me, to me, when I see in the morning, when I went to school, hungry and very hungry and without sleep because of the noise of the airplanes over our house. And it was a great, and großes Wunder, great miracle for me that there was a dropping of the parachute on the way to school and even on the schoolyard. And we were allowed to go out, to run around. I was so little and I can't catch any parachute. I decided then to go with my mother to Airfield Tempelhof. It was a very bad experience I had there because of a boy catched it away. This parachute for my face, and I remember I was crying the whole way home. I was crying, and when we come back to the apartment, my grandma told me, "Don't cry, do something." And then I decided to write a letter to my chocolate uncle. This was my chocolate uncle. Chocolate was so a high wish to for me, so great wish, and to write a letter. And I have done it secretly without that my grandma or mother got to know it. And without a stamp, I got it to the post box next morning. And yeah. And then when I was coming home from school, I told about this situation, what I've done. And my grandma said, "Oh, you are so foolish. there will be nothing. I wrote in this letter that every day my chocolate uncle would fly over my house. You see, I was 7 years old, and the airplanes were so near for me when I was standing on the roof or on the fourth stage there, or in the fourth apartment there. And I was ducking the whole garden for the hens. I wrote to them there were wild hens in the yard, and you must see this. And what happened? No dropping. And I remember when the foggy November, I came back from school. My grandma gave me a letter, a brown envelope with a chewing gum in it and a lollipop, a lifesaver. And the chewing gum was unknown to me, and the chewing gum I gave to the black market for kids then. And I have a glass marble up to this time. I found it last year again. I missed it, but I told every time I have this done. And the lollipop was up to Christmas because I hoped that my aunt would send me chocolate from Switzerland. But nothing happened in this way because it was forbidden a private post during the airlift to give to Berlin in this way. And my aunt was going to Switzerland. She must go to Switzerland during war because she helped Dutch families to escape from Berlin to Switzerland. And I was usually I wrote a letter. This was a good connection, and therefore I had the idea to write to my chocolate uncle. Okay, that was the best. Was the letter inside? The letter where your father told me that he not every day was flying over my house, and he was so busy, and therefore this letter. But to me was the best thing that happened, that we got this letter, not a parachute, because this letter was for me a sign that somewhere is looking for me, for us kids in this bad situation in Berlin. This parachute dropping means hope for a better time after. Irgendwann, yes, and it was hope. It was, I can't express it, the feeling. It's so great and so thankful to this, what Gail Halvorsen had done for this Berliners and for whole Germany, for whole Europe. And it was, and you remember, as now we are friends, former enemies are friends now. And and for me, it means that the letter was contact to the Americans, to the good will from the Americans. I have it all time with me, even when I was in university and so on. And I gave it this for a secret to my husband. And he told him that this man, this pilot, is my father. My father, symbol of father. Because I have never contact my father. He has never seen me. And and Peter told then when an open day he was speaking then, so high officer standing there, not knowing that was the commander of the airfield Tempelhof there at this time, and he invited it indeed to the family, to the family, and as is. It's so wonderful that the Halvorsen family was coming, Gail Halvorsen and his wife and two of sons. They were playing with our two sons together. And from this time, it was a wonderful friendship, I think. And I'm feeling like a family member of you and of the Halvorsen family. And I think you are also a part of our family, even we are seeing not so often now because of the now the situation. But last year's was a wonderful remembrance of last year. We were so many times together, and also with you, Denise, and I miss your father, and I miss, of course, Alter. Alter, I have now here Ohrringe. You see, this means here. She bought it sometimes when we were shopping in Salt Lake City. It is salt from the Salt Sea, from Salt Lake. And excuse me. Thank you for speaking to you, Sand. Perhaps you have some question I have not answered.
Oh, yes. Tell about the letter that you wrote. Well, you told a little bit about the letter you wrote to my family, my father, in 72. That's when Peter, your husband Peter, invited my parents, and finally they came to your home for the chicken dinner.
And yeah, the story with the chicken thing. Also, chicken. Your father asked you, "It's a chicken from 48." And I was my English is not so good, and I said, "Repeat it once more, sir." And he was laughing there, and then he gave him a good hug, and then it was all okay. I think that was a moment. Yes, that's, I feel the daughter of him. And
So in 1948, he wrote you that letter you were telling about. And then in 1970 to 74, he was the commandant at Tempelhof. And that's when, on one of the open house days that the military would have and invite the Germans, that's when Peter approached my family, my father, and wanted to give an invitation to your house. And then he kept sending the invitation until finally my parents came to your home, and then you went to your cupboard and you pulled out the letter. And then tell about all the other times they came to your home to visit and what my father did on this letter. Tell about that.
The face of the letter changed. On the back of the letter are signatures from your father and from my chocolate uncle, also on the front, of course. And I think one time I had it with you and with me in Utah when I was invited to your family staying there in Locust Lane, yes. And then he wrote the same, often he wrote here in Berlin.
Mercedes, talk a little bit louder. Yes. I don't know what happened. You got softer. Can you speak a little louder?
Yeah, no, I'm speaking loud. I tried.
Yeah, I don't know. It's softer now. Mm-hmm. So just keep going.
Yes. The letter changed of the face. Also on the back side, there's also signatures of your father. And not nearly every time he wrote a new note. I think he was more than 30 times in our home. Also when we were on the opening of the embassy, Berlin German embassy, he wrote a signal. And last year, of course, when he was in Berlin, and also, yeah. It's a historical letter. I can't imagine to this time that it was so a good ambassador, this letter.
Yes, and many times you have taken him to your door to look out over the area where the white chickens used to live, down between the apartment building. And I have seen that place too. You showed me that place.
To this part, there are no blue flowers, and we have the party area, and so for the family and for families in the house also, yes, and it changed it. My youngest son, Christian, gave their four white hands wooden hands to this place where the former time where the, the chicken were. It's a symbolic.
Oh, yes. Now you have chickens again?
No, we haven't chickens again. Yeah. Yeah, chickens were, to this time were necessary because it was 48, and after war, it was necessary to have this for the black market, like cigarettes, and they changed it to meat and also to bread and so. And my mm-hmm. mother was going there to support our family because she can't work. She was ill. And my grandmother also was ill, and we were the only situation. It's most normal for other kids also in Berlin, without father. Yeah, and many were waiting the whole life for their father, and it was the women of Berlin. They was very hard and strong, and they hoped that the West Allied would stay, and mm-hmm. reconstructed Berlin with the help of the Americans, the British, and the French.
Uh-huh. Tell us some things that you do now to talk about the airlift, how you visit the schools, and you're very active with helping children.
Yeah. I'm going to school to teach about the situation about 70 years ago. And I do this since, I think, to school site 1978. But also I'm sending with international schools, also in Americans, in Wiesbaden, in Stuttgart, in Ansbach, in Mannheim. I was in Vornheim, and of course, in Berlin, and the greatest event was 7 years ago. A Berlin school has the name of Gail Halvorsen. This is the Gail Halvorsen School in Zehlendorf. This is so good that Gail Halvorsen is now a symbol in the schools, and also I'm now the teacher are preparing some for the 100th birthday, of course, but the feeling, the good feeling, all spreading all over the world from this school, because they are, in former times they had a connection to the to the Balticum, and then they opened this connection, also contact to USA and to France and to England, and I think they will be the students. They will be good ambassadors. Mm-hmm.
Good, good. So what was the effect of the Berlin airlift on Germany, do you think?
Oh, God. To this time when I was a child, I couldn't see the whole political affair. But now I think it was that's a good ending of the airlift. Was the first good step to that Europe would not become Russian or communist. Then the East Europe was in communism, and Italian was a great party, and France was a great party of communism. And the Russian were waiting to come to whole Germany. And this is General Clay had a good idea to do this in this way with the support of General Tanner, and we have also a Clay Alley in Berlin, of course, and it's a symbol, a well-known symbol to whole Germany, West Germany, and now East Germany. And about 30 years now, we are now one big Yeah, a little big, yes, or not so big like USA state now, Bundesrepublik Deutschland, and the interest in the eastern part is also in a good spreading in a good way, and I go to also Saxonia and also to Rostock and to support the idea of the Völkerverständigung, that means for me that the people come together in a good way. Mm-hmm. And they must see what their roots are, why Germany is now a democratic system. We have a democratic system. You can see it when there are events in Berlin. Yesterday they had tried a little demonstration against masks of corona masks. Yes, and wow. They can so do it, but it's not good for the whole community. Yes, yeah, they infect the others. Yeah, and we have a democratic, and therefore it's not forbidden to say what you mean, and that we have from USA, this democratic system. Yes, we have. That's a feeling before. We had a dictation in Nazi time, and Nazi time also communism is dictature.
Yeah.
Freedom.
Yeah. Freedom, definitely.
Yeah.
And I hope the next generation of German citizens can remember this.
Yeah, and I will do my best for this. I think.
Do you want to tell a little bit about Peter and the student exchange and how you came to visit my parents in Provo, Utah with Peter and some students?
Yeah, in 1978, your family invited us to stay in your home in Provo. And Peter and Johannes had the idea to have a student exchange, and also with Brent Chambers. He was a teacher, German teacher there in Provo High School. And this exchange went about 20 years. And yes, it's going on a little bit, I think, from the State Ballet School Berlin. They had a contact also to Ballet Utah. And in Salt Lake City, and I think in this new school from my grandkid Victoria, they have a German-American partnership program there. Perhaps Victoria will visit with this program USA, yes, and family, to see living life in family, yes.
Yes, very nice, good.
And there are many students, even Peter is passed away, they have former students I have contact from this time, from this German-American partnership program. It is very interesting that they are sometimes in high positions here in Germany, and I think it was a good thing that Gail was and has protection about this school exchange.
Yes. How many times did you come to my parents' home in Provo? Was it three times or?
Yeah, I was there only, I think, three or four times there, because of the four kids here, I must look for the family, and Peter was every 2 years, he was there with a group of from the Gottfried Keller Gymnasium, and former time from the other gymnasium in Tannenberg Gymnasium in Steglitz. And all 2 years there were also Bernd Chambers and his other teachers were then from in Berlin, but in the families.
Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. That was Keller Gymnasium that Peter was working?
Once what?
Where did Peter work? Keller Gymnasium?
Yeah, Keller Gymnasium, yes. Gottfried Keller Gymnasium, yeah. In Charlottenburg. Ja, und davor im Tannenberg-Gymnasium in Steglitz.
Okay.
Ja. Ja. It was a chemistry teacher and physics. This English, he learned it in school, and I think it was better in French language. Even it is work, it was work, it work was working, yes? It was going on, yeah? All the time, yeah?
Okay, good. Yeah, Peter, it was wonderful. And your children, I'm sure that your experience in the airlift affected your children and how they...
Yeah. It's very interesting. My grandkids are on the same school where 70 years ago, where the parachute dropping I saw in school. And when they had a festival, I think it was 4 years ago, they, okay, schließen, yeah. And they had a parachute dropping also from the roof there. And the festival was on, because Victoria told about this in school, part of the festival was this parachute dropping and memories of the history in during the airlift. Very good. And also from kindergarten, from the John F. Kennedy Schule, when they are here in my home and in my garden, we have the parachute dropping from the highest window on the tower there. We have in the backyard the tower, and it's very good, this feeling for the children. And also from Museum Fassberg, Erinnerungsstätte in Fassberg in Niedersachsen. Uh-huh. Your father was flying also coal from Berlin, from Fassberg to Berlin. There are students coming to see the airport for Tempelhof. Now it's now looking how it's looking now. And then I tell them about this time. And every year I was going, this year I was not there. Every year on the 27th of August, I'm in Fassberg because of the ceremony of Kranzniederlegung, memory ceremony of the airlift veterans and
the wreath laying. For the airlift veterans on August 27th in Fassburg?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that. So you were there just
This year I was not there because of Corona. I was then in the Halvorsen school. And because of the preparing of the festival on the 9th of October, they will have the festival in the school and they are preparing some things, books and so on, and videos for the birthday of your father.
Oh, yeah. How nice.
I hope that I have the... And say gives us some ideas to manage this in a good way. Also, I have some connections there to TVs and also to the writing press and so writer paper press. Yes, yeah.
Oh, very good. please give them the greetings from the Halvorsens.
Yeah, mache ich. Of course, I will do it.
Ah,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they have a teacher now, Monica, named Monica Floyd. She is, her husband is American, and the children were also on the high schools and universities in America. And she think it's a good idea from the school that she is doing this because she is knowing about the American feelings.
Oh, she's a teacher there.
Yes, she's a teacher for English.
Ah,
not for American, for English, you see. The Germans are very astonished when we say, yeah, a teacher for English, say, and also in America. Yes, okay. Yeah, that's good.
Do you want to tell anything about your family, about your parents or your grandparents? Or?
Oh, yeah, my grandparents, one of my grandparents, my grandfather was an architect, and he was building the Berliner Dome, the cupola. And many churches in Berlin. And then during the Nazi time, he was forbidden to work because he was not in the party, in the Nazi party. And he was allowed to look for Jewish immobilien, you see, belonging to the Dutch people, and you must give this back to the state there, to the Nazi state. And it was his great problem to do this. And he lost of this in this way also. He lost in the in prison, the family lost good friends. Concentration camps, yes. And this, I think this formed my also my give me an inspiration to talk about history also during the Nazi time, after time, and this to see it's not only I speak not only about the airlift, and I'm speaking also on the time before, the whole development, and that I have their teachers in the school say were not speaking about the situation during the war or time before, and of the were in the party. And in my school class in the high school, there was a daughter from a resistance officer, and she has problems with the teachers there. Her father is ein Verräter. You mean? Verräter, that means he is not, he have done not the right thing for the former government. And she is living now in Italy because she couldn't live with this idea in Germany.
So she had to escape.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. They must settle on to Italy to
Oh, I see a traitor. Ferreta is traitor.
Yeah, traitor. Yes. Okay. Thank you. The teachers were the same like a time before, like the Nazi time, yeah. And the same problem had done the former East Berliner teachers when the reunion to West Berlin, to West Germany was, yes. Yeah, the same teachers, yeah. And therefore, it is wirklich, sometimes it's difficult for me to say about the whole history, development of Bundesrepublik Deutschland, yes, also to the former eastern part of Germany. And when you see the rechtsradikal, the anti-democratic system now in Germany, it's very hard for me. Yeah, I'm very... furious about the system, and now noch Corona, and they say, okay, yeah, it's a fake. No, it's no fake Corona. Yes,
yeah. You have seen so much of the history of Germany with your parents, your grandparents, and
you remember my aunt told she must leave Germany, escape, because she was helping Dutch families now. And
she was helping Jewish families.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and therefore, then there was on the list for the concentration camp, and my grandfather became the information about this, and because he has old friends, they were in the Nazi party, and they were coming together to in the evening sometimes, and they told him about the situation. His daughter is now, and she was married to a Swiss diplomat, and therefore she could go out to Germany with any trouble.
So did she live there her whole life?
Yes, she was never would never come back to Berlin. I saw her once in Garmisch-Partenkirchen one time for 3 weeks, and this was in 1945. And
Well, do you have anything more you would like to tell? You want to tell a little bit about your own children?
Oh, my own children, yes. This is very funny. To my own children, yes. Eric is married to a former from GDR. Marion, yes. She is surrounding from Berlin, and their father and their mother was to this event when they married. They came from St. Petersburg to Berlin to this marriage.
Oh.
Marriage. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's in 96, yes, okay.
Yes, I remember, I showed some pictures.
In 96 we started then the round table for the 50th anniversary in August, yes. And 50th anniversary, you remember I was at Erfurt Tempelhof speaking in the name of the Berlin, thank you. I was elected by the government of Germany to this because yes, I was well known, I think, up to this time, Sean, and they have two daughters. Yeah, they are staying in our house here, in my house. And then the eldest is George, and he has two boys. And very good. His wife is. Had good contact to Americans because her father was American soldier in former time.
Oh.
And this is funny situation in Baden-Württemberg, yeah, from Baden-Württemberg, from the south of Germany, yes. And he was staying in Berlin, in Germany. Yeah, he was staying in Berlin up this when all the time. Yes, and then we have Marianne. Marianne is our daughter. She has the best restaurant of Germany, near Checkpoint Charlie, and it's the Tim Rauer restaurant, and it's belong to her, and he must cook because of this two stars. He must cook there in a good way. Then when he wouldn't done this, and the service of Marianne wouldn't so good, they would not be the best in former time, in future not the best Germany restaurant. Yes.
What's the name of the restaurant? What's the name of the restaurant?
Tim Rauer.
Tim Rauer.
Yeah, you remember Tim Rauer was also in Schloss Charlottenburg, when your father was here in 2014?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a government there with Frau Dr. Merkel, and your father was also had an invitation. Uh-huh. And he is also a cook for the representations events for the governments. And I think many government members are going to this restaurant. Okay, and then we have the youngest son is Christian. He's a ballet dancer and also a musical dancer. And he has now he is a teacher in a ballet school in Potsdam. He has up to 60 students. And he is very, very busy because of the situation, the hard situation for the students to learn because of the mask and the distance and so on, just because of the situation of the virus.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, and he has a sweet wife, Sarah, and they have no children, but they have two little cats. They are like kids.
And Marianne, does she have children?
No, she hasn't. No, this was, yes, she hasn't.
George and Eric.
Yeah, George and Eric. Uh-huh.
Yeah, and George has two boys and Eric has two daughters.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it's wonderful to talk with you. Do you have anything more you would like to say?
Well, I would only say thank you to what your father have done, and this is so historical idea. I think it was the best he could do for Germany, that he was dropping these parachutes. Mm-hmm. And, this is your father is so so good. It's a wonderful to meet him because he is so kind and fatherless and I think best ambassador, American ambassador we had in Germany, and he is staying on all the time. American ambassadors or British or French are going. Sometimes I have contact to them to over the time. It's very interesting to have contact after the official time in Berlin, and I have their contacts to former ambassadors, American ambassadors. Yes. And I give this connection also, or this contact, I try to give it to the students in also to the Halvorsen School, and I think I'm feeling a part of the Halvorsen School because Michael Notbohm and we had the idea to have the name to the school, and when the lady there of the government saw me there, and we saw and the idea and what happened, how we can do it, and the students and the parents of the students says, okay, it was a great luck for Berlin to have this school and can spread this idea. These students can give this idea of friendship to the others.
That's wonderful, Mercedes. That's wonderful. I'm gonna say him out with my father. Aufzumachen ist.
Ja, do it.
Er hat seine Kleider nicht. He's not dressed. Seine.
Yeah.
What was that? Okay.
Yeah. Perhaps you will come next year to Berlin when we have the not the troubles with the airplanes there that we have the so on. We can go. And quarantine then afterwards, 14 days and so is the test and so on.
Oh, das ist schrecklich.
Ja.
Oh. Ja, wir planen jetzt seinen 100. Geburtstag.
Ja.
And I know he wants to talk to you, but er ist jetzt im Badezimmer und er hat sich nicht. Also.
Ja. Yeah. Of course. Yeah.
Do you want? Yeah. Do you want to talk?
That I would be with you at this at a birthday, but
no. Everything is. We did not expect this for his birthday.
No. This is possible to do. Yes.
So I wonder, could we call you tomorrow at a later time so my father could talk to you?
Yeah.
Maybe 7 Uhr, 1900 your time.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. 1 hour later. Yes.
2 hours later, maybe.
Yeah. We have 6 Uhr, 18 Uhr, 19 Uhr. Yeah.
Hm. 19. Hast du Zeit morgen 19 Uhr?
Ja.
Und dann schicke ich dir noch einmal einen Link und.
Ja.
Und dann kann mein Vater mit dir sprechen.
Ja, gut. Probieren wir es.
Okay.
Ja, okay. Ja.
Vielen Dank, Mercedes.
Ja, see you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Tschüss.
Tschüss.